Groups are handy for organizing your objects, but what if you want to use the same groups on different pages? We have another type of group called a component that makes reuse easy. To begin, I've reset my page to the way it was at the beginning of the previous video, with one of my labels ungrouped. As before, I'll right-click on my selected objects, and this time, group as component. This object has a few different properties than the group. The content section refers to the total area displayed in the component. Think of the component as a small page being displayed on the main TGML. Content width and content height are the sizes of that page, while height and width refer to the scaled size on this page. If I resize the component, the size changes, but the content size does not. We have another property called clip. Again, if my component is a small page, clipping will cut off any objects that fall outside the component boundaries. I'll demonstrate by setting this to true, then adjusting my square's position. Also notice that a component has position properties available, whereas groups do not. This means that functions requiring access to these values, like bindings, exposes, animations, and scripts, can move the component as a whole. One last thing to note in the object tree is how bindings are named. I'll give my component a name, to keep track of it, then bind the text content the same way we did before. Down in the test pane, the binding name is listed as the component name dot the bind name. This doesn't affect our preview at all, but will be critical in the next video section when we start binding real data. Now for the real reason you're here. The component library. Each of these categories is a group of pre-built components that we can use on the screen. We'll come back to these later. For now, I'm going to use my components, although I could also right-click and create a new category. To add a component to the library, I'll drag it from the object tree, not the page, and drop it in the category. I can give it a name that will show up in the library, as well as a description. Now, I can drag this component out and drop it on the page as many times as I want. Moreover, my component libraries are persistent. If I need to switch to another page or create a new one, the component will still be there to use. Now that the component is in the library, I may need to make some changes to it. For this, I'll right-click and edit. A new window opens up, and now you see what I meant when I said a component is like a small page. Aside from the metadata fields that describe it in the library, a component has very similar properties to a TGML page. All of my usual editing tools are available here, including the preview tab. When I'm done, I'll save and close, and my component library will be updated. Components are a critical part of building graphics. In fact, most of your development will involve adding and editing components rather than basic graphics, as we'll see later. In the meantime, let's move on to layers, our last type of object group. Until then, thank you.